The Rust programming language has a bit of a reputation that it's hard to learn. Certainly when I learned it in 2017, I really struggled with it. But it's 2024 now and I think things have changed. I'm putting my time where my mouth is and I'm making a series on how to learn Rust as quickly and I hope as painlessly as possible. This series has a free accompanying book, check the description below. My name is Daniel, welcome to Iris. We're not going to jump into coding today though, I'm sorry. In TTRPG terms, this is session zero. I just want to talk about why you should or should not learn Rust, what other learning resources are out there, and how this series is going to compare. Why should you learn Rust? I could tell you that it's blazingly fast, that it holds your hand and makes it hard to make mistakes. Its first-party tooling is second to none. It has a mature ecosystem of tools and libraries, and it has an amazingly kind and supportive community. All of these statements are true. And all of these are great reasons to pick up Rust for your next personal or professional project. But in my mind, there's one reason everyone should consider trying out Rust. Because it's fun. Seriously, Rust is my happy place. Sure, like any language, it has its frustrations. But when I'm working with Rust, it makes me feel smart. I have less horrible surprises than other languages I use professionally, and have a lot of confidence that my code will just work. That I won't need to go back and fix a ton of bugs. And if I do, I'll be able to quickly understand old code, write new tests, and fix any problems. And I'm not alone. Since its 1.0 release, Rust has been Stack Overflow's most loved language 8 years in a row. This isn't just fanatics like me saying it's great, but the percentage of people who used the language last year and still want to use it the next year. Okay, but why shouldn't you learn Rust? As much as I love Rust, there is a reason it may not be the language for you, and it's a big one. If you're looking to learn a language specifically to get a job, Rust is not a good language for you right now. That said, things are slowly changing. More businesses are picking it up due to its low cost to write, run, and maintain. The biggest cost for businesses looking to adopt Rust is training people, but there are more and more of us out there. Perhaps 2024 will finally be the tipping point. Nonetheless, right now, if you're looking for a job, better languages to learn would be TypeScript or Python. As well as being more marketable, they are genuinely great languages, and Rust will still be here when the time is right for you. My goal here is to get you into Rust, and if this series isn't for you, or if you want to supplement Iris with other resources, these are in my mind the other best ways to learn Rust. The Rust Programming Language Book, also known as the Living Book, is where I started 7 years ago, but it's had 7 years of growth and it's amazing. The main differences between the book and Iris is that the book focuses on how the language works while Iris focuses on how it's written. We will talk about how the language works, but only in the context of why we write it the way that we do. Iris does, however, follow a similar path to both the official book and Rustlings, our next resource, so it should be easy to jump between all three. Rustlings is a learn by doing guide to Rust. It works by giving you specific exercises to help you understand the language a bit at a time. The gamification of the course makes it really fun, and I still use Rustlings to help keep myself sharp. Rust by example does exactly what it says on the tin. It focuses on the implementation of the Rust language. This is great to quickly look things up if you know what you want to know. However, there are some minor pseudo anti-patterns in here. So if you don't already know that they are anti-patterns, you might accidentally copy them. Don't worry though, we'll cover these here, but also tools like Clippy, which we'll also cover, will be quick to point them out. Okay, so why use Iris if there are these other great resources? Idiomatic Rust, in simple steps, lines up nicely with these other resources and can supplement them, or vice versa. While other resources focus on simply learning the language, Iris focuses on how and why we write the language the way that we do. This might seem like the same thing, but here we'll ramp up on idioms quickly so that you can understand other people's code, as well as write code that other people can understand. This matters. My biggest hot take of the software industry is that software engineers are not paid to write code. We're paid to solve problems. The best software engineers I've worked with have solved problems without writing a single line of code, and the cheapest code to maintain is the code you did not write. Beyond this though, solving problems, even with code, takes understanding and collaboration. If when you join a team, you already understand why they write the code the way that they do, you're going to become productive much faster. In the next video, we're finally going to cover installing Rust, setting up your development environment, and writing your first program. I'm also going to teach you one neat trick that will be like a superpower for your learning and development skills. And if that's good bait, then I look forward to seeing you next time.